guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you're having a lovely day. Is the sun too much? Yeah, but it's better. I hope you're having a lovely day. So for today's video, I am vlogging. So today is the Friday, the 11th of May, and tomorrow on the 12th of May, I am going to Ed Sheeran with my friends in Galway, and I thought I'd bring you guys along with me. I haven't vlogged in a really long time, but I've vlogged, but I just haven't posted a vlog in a really long time. And I'm starting it now because tomorrow will be hectic that I probably won't be able to like properly talk. We'll see. I'll try my best. I'm so excited. I'm just getting a few bits of my outfit together, but I'll show you that tomorrow anyway. Oh, I'm so excited. I love Ed Sheeran. My husband. Yeah, so I'm so excited. So right now it is 5:20 past 5, so I have some homework to do because I have a busy week ahead, so I'm gonna go do that right now. It's a beautiful day. I'm seeing Ed Sheeran. I am so excited. I think it's 8:10. Yeah, it's 8:10. Eek. Yes, I'm gonna try and get a little bit of schoolwork done. Someone's walking and they just saw me vlogging. Eek. I'm gonna try and get a little bit of schoolwork done and then start getting ready, I guess. It's actually a beautiful day out. I will show you. Guys, we're just ready and we're about to go. Are we excited?
Yeah!
No response. Thanks. So we're just off the bus now and we're walking. Are you excited?
Yeah!
I wonder where the girls are. Are they like... So we're here now, guys.
Do you want to be in it? No.
Yay! Wait. Yeah, you're in it. Yeah, here now and we're just waiting. Yay! It's very, very tight.
Thank you.
I know what's happening all in your head, yeah. I know what's happening in our bed, yeah.
Your phone is buzzing, so pick it up. I know she calling, so what the fuck? I should've known that she stays a cheater. See, here we are. And there goes the alarm ringing in my head. Like somebody said, don't you trust him, no.
Don't feel like putting makeup on my cheeks. You are alone. Love every single part of my body. Top to the bottom. I'm not a supermodel from a magazine. I'm okay when I'm being perfect, cause that's perfect to me. Cause that's perfect to me. This one. Well, who knows what this one is? This is a song that I did with Clean Bandit and Shauna Paul. This one is called Rockabye.
To this one because we're pretty freezing, right?
Yeah.
So we need to get our bodies warm. This one is called
Hi.
This one is called FRIENDS.
I love her.
Yeah. tonight. Cause in a fight, we'll fly to the motherland. Set it off to another land.
So when I ask for crowd participation, everyone's kind of looking around, checking if it's their dad or their boyfriend. So when I put my arm in the air, Galway, I want everyone here to put their arm in the air. When I say everyone, I mean everyone. And after the beat drops, we are going to bounce like this as one. So when my arm goes in the air, your arm goes in the air, and if you're next to your dad and he's not doing it, give him a stern look.
All it can hurt.
found a love for me. Darling, just dive right in, follow my lead. I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. I never knew you were someone waiting for me. Me slow, your heart is all I know, and in your eyes you're holding mine. Baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath that you heard it, that you look perfect tonight. I felt alone, stronger than anyone. She shares my dreams, I hope someday I'll share her home. To carry love, to carry children on my own. We are still kids and we're so in love, fighting against all odds. I know we'll be alright inside. Darling, just hold my hand. Be my girl, I'll be your man. I see my future. Singing to our favorite song. When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Loving you look perfect tonight. Go away, if you have a light on your phone, when you hold it in the air, right?
Baby, I'm born and then you think I'm the one who's asking the real question. Who's the student? whiskey and wine, to get up along to the cold air of the night. I'm on margaritas and another bottle of wine. I'm smiling and I feel you in a song that I got in the back of my head.
Thank you for coming out on a Saturday. I hope you got home.
guys, I'm just home from Ed Sheeran and it is 2 o'clock. I had the most amazing time. I have only 9 minutes left of storage on my phone because I filmed that much. I had the best time and I'm just I'm very tired. It was just such an amazing night. I think I might go to bed and just talk to you about it in the morning when I'm not like half wrecked and like don't even know what I'm saying. But 100% the best night of my life. Like I got so emotional because he's just, I just love Ed. Right, so I'm gonna go to bed and I'll talk to you in the morning. Hey guys, excuse the mess. I'm just in the midst of cleaning up my room after last night because I was mad. But I just wanted to talk about the Ed Sheeran concert. I get a bit emotional talking about it because like myself and my friends that I went with all love Ed Sheeran so much. His music means a lot to us, and the fact that we got to see him and we're in the same breathing space as him says so much. It was incredible, by far one of the best nights of my life. Like it's something I will never ever forget, and I get a bit emotional. I think the reason why it was so good is because the day, like my friend said, was perfect. Nothing went wrong. Nothing that could have gone wrong went wrong. You know, we were with lovely people. We got there safely on the bus. The people on the bus were lovely. The bus driver was amazing. We didn't get lost. We weren't late getting in. We were right up the front. And we were surrounded by amazing, incredible people who, oh my God, just amazing. I think everything about that night was brilliant. The supporting acts were amazing. Bioga were amazing. Jamie Lawson was amazing. I almost said his name wrong. Jamie Lawson was amazing because I think I was listening to his music for ages, like on the Indie Air channel. And when, I'm not gonna lie, like when he came on, I didn't think of him. But when he played, like I didn't realize that I had known him. But when he played Cold in Ohio, my heart just did this funny thing because I was like, I know that song and that song means so much to me. So, oh, it's just incredible. Anne Marie is such a positive woman. Oh my God. She's amazing. She's just goals. Like seriously, she went out there looking fabulous, was giving supportive messages about being positive and not having to look amazing all the time. As in, like, you don't have to wear makeup to look amazing. You don't have to be dolled up all the time. You don't have to be like everybody else if you don't want to be. Just be yourself. And it was just lovely. Ed Sheeran is the cutest person I have ever met. Well, I haven't met him, but like I was in the same place as him. He's so cute. He's so funny. He actually, at one point of the concert, there was like a gap at the one point I did see. I'll get back to that in a minute. There was a gap and I like waved at him and I like smiled. And I feel like he looked at me and smiled back because he also waved, or he smiled. And I felt like he was looking at me. He probably wasn't, but just like I was just like, hi. It was amazing. One of his songs that means the world to me is The A-Team. That song was almost 10 years old now, but I remember listening to that song when I was about 12, 13 and being in a kind of a dark place and not knowing who I was and all that stuff. And that song helped me through that. So I did get a bit emotional when that song came on. Lovely. And I See Fire as well is a lovely song. Basically, all of his songs are amazing and I just had the best time. There was also this lovely woman, actually. So we were, there was like loads of tall people in front of us, which is really annoying because like I feel like if you're tall, you should have consideration for other people around you, because obviously I'm 5 foot nothing. I was like half the size of the person in front of me. Well, no, that's a lie. She was about here-ish. And I couldn't see. And then this woman who was behind me, she was from London, and she was like, here, you go in front of me, because she also couldn't see because there was like a really tall person in front of her. So by putting me in front of her, she could see, and then the tall person has to move over, if that makes sense. But yeah, she was like, it's so unfair that tall people, they wouldn't move for us, because it's not like it's costing them anything. If we go in front of them, they can still see. So no, it was really annoying. And there was this poor girl toward the right of me. He was about here on me. I'd say she was about 17. She looks young anyway, so she was about here on me. And I'm quite small anyway. But there was like a 6'6" guy in front of her. She asked him if she could move, if she could go in front of him. And he said no. Like, he would have seen. And she didn't see anything. And I felt so bad for her. Like,
people are just pricks sometimes. That was the only thing that annoyed me. The tall people that wouldn't move. So I would suggest wearing high-ish heels, even if it's going to be sore. Like, I've never got a worse pain in my legs in my life, but it was worth it, and I had the best time. Even though there was tall people in front of me, I'm still honoured and just grateful that I was that close to Ed Sheeran, because we never even thought we would have been that close to Ed Sheeran. And because we thought we were a bit late, because we started queuing up around 4 o'clock, and I'm just getting ready to show you this, and I signed a thing to make sure that I was over 18, and I was minding the people that I was with, my two friends, and we went in and they gave us these, and we were like, we didn't even know what this meant. So we were like, oh yeah, that's fine. So in we go in, and it's called The Pit, and he was like, just show me this. We went in, we got our places, and we were there, like, right in front of the stage. I was shocked, because I did think we were going to be, like, way far behind, because I thought you had to wait ages to be that close, but you didn't. And that was amazing, and I just had the best time. I just feel very, like, inspired and grateful that I got to go. Ed Sheeran's music inspires me a lot, because he's just a mastermind, as Bjoga called him, a ginger Jesus. Like, that's what he is. He's incredible. I just feel very positive coming out of it, and right now I have to clean up and do some study and stuff, but I suppose you do have to work after having fun. But I feel so free and happy, and I just had the best time surrounded by incredible people that I would not want to change. And just when you're there and you're surrounded by amazing people and you're surrounded by a positive atmosphere, listening to the person that you love singing, nothing is better. Nothing. So I'm over the moon. So I'm going to end my vlog here. I hope it's okay. I'll be filming more. It's just exams are coming up, but I'm in fifth year, so I have a lot of tests coming up. But I will be filming more for the summer, and I have loads of ideas. So I will talk to you in my next video. Bye.